Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about using emoji characters on the iPad, iPhone, and on the Mac. So here you can see I'm composing a text message, and I've put in it a character that is actually not a letter, but a picture of a face. And it's a full color graphic image. And you may get a lot of messages like this, but you may not know how to put them in your own messages. And in fact, not only can you put them in messages, but you can put them in emails, you can put them in your documents, you can type them just as you can type a regular character, just have to know how to do it. So on an iPhone, start by going to Settings. Under Settings, go to General, and then from there, scroll down to Keyboard. And here you've got a option for keyboards there. And this allows you to add multiple keyboards. Now, most people just have the one keyboard, in this case English, but you can tap on add a new keyboard. Now say you occasionally type in another language like Chinese or Japanese or Greek or any of these, you can add it as a secondary or third or fourth keyboard to what you've got. You can also add one called Emoji. Let's go and do that. So I have two keyboards now. Now when I return to my text message app, I can see that I've got the bottom of my keyboard right there. I've got the space bar, I've got the dictation microphone, and here I've got this little globe, and that actually lets me switch keyboards. Most keyboards are international style keyboards, so the globe kind of makes sense, but not so much for emoji. Now when I tap that, I get all these cool special characters, and I can just tap one, like it's a character on a keyboard, to type it. And you can see the dots at the top, I can actually swipe and scroll through them. Not only can I scroll through all of these here, but I'm on the faces keyboard. You can see down here at the bottom where it has the little face. I can switch that to say the recently used one, which will give you the ones you've most recently used. But also you can tap here and you can see a whole different set of animals and plants and flowers and moons and things. You can do these other symbols here, transportation and map style symbols. And some symbols that are related to numbers and arrows and all sorts of things. So you can see there are tons of different symbols, and you can scroll through all of these, and any one that you want you can add just by typing it. Then to switch back to your regular keyboard, tap the globe again, and it rotates through the keyboards. In this case, my other keyboard's English US, so it just goes back to that. So I can easily go back and forth between them like that. Now on the iPad you can do the same thing. So you go to Settings, and General, Keyboard, Keyboards, add a new keyboard, and then you find Emoji and add that. And then when you're done with that, you can jump to your Messages app, and then you've got that little keyboard globe button there, and you can swipe through all the different emoji characters here and add any one that you want. And you're not restricted to using this in just text messages. You can use it in emails. You can even use it here in Pages. So anything that has a keyboard you can use. So in Pages here I can select some art, and you can actually enlarge the characters and use these as clip art. So for instance, I wanted to use a crescent moon there. You can see I've got it set at 72 point. I can change the point size and make it larger and smaller. You can't make it too big, but you can make it large enough that it becomes kind of useful to use as little bits of clip art sometimes in your documents. So you can also do this on your Mac. Now of course on your Mac you can't swap out your physical keyboard for an emoji keyboard. But you can go into System Preferences, and under there go to Language and Text, not Keyboards. Go to Input Sources, and there you can turn on the Keyboard and Character Viewer. So once you have that, you can see up here in the menu bar right above me is a little icon that you click on, and then you can choose Show Character Viewer. And that comes up with this list of characters here, and one of the options there is emoji. And here you can look at pretty much the same characters as you saw before, and if you have your cursor inside of a rich text document, here I can actually insert a character by just double clicking on it there. And then like with on the iPad there, I can make this a larger size so I can see it and add more characters. So you can see it selected the Apple Color Emoji Character Set. I can go back in the Character Viewer and select even more. I just double tap and it enters them in. You can see they're pretty decent quality. You could certainly use these as clip art. Now on the Mac you can also use the emoji characters inside of email messages. Just make sure you bring up the characters palette there, and then just double click on any that you want to include. And you can use these in the Messages app as well. You're down here typing and you can select any one of these and it will insert it. But it can be even easier than that for some of the characters, because if you look, you've got this little smiley face next to your typing window. You tap on that and you can choose from some of the most common ones. So it's very easy to insert these. So you may have in fact gotten messages from people that have these basic ones in there and they know how to do this. But you can get a lot more by using the characters palette here and choosing from the many more options that you've got. One advantage to these is they're all very standard, and if you actually roll over them you'll see like a description at the bottom like grin, and then you'll see the characters that represent it. So if the person on the other end is using a system that doesn't have these emoji characters, they should be able to get the regular characters that you see here at the bottom right corner of this little window. And also likewise, if you type one of these, so let's say let's type for the regular smile, it should translate to the regular emoji character when it gets to the other end. Though I can't confirm that. I suppose it depends on what the person has at the other end. So there's how to use the emoji characters on your iPad, your iPhone, and your Mac. Hope you found this useful. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.